continue to say, down with the billionaires, we can't stand the rich. A lot of people want to be rich. So is it the right message that the Democrats are going with?
It's so effing wrong.
Whoa.
I've talked to Schumer. I've talked to Wyden. I've talked to Pelosi.
And said what?
And I said, if you use the term billionaire again, I'm done.
Why?
Because it's aspirational. I didn't start with anything. Just penalize everyone that's done well. We all want to do well. And we should be the party of doing well. We should be a party of business and leadership. And it is very, very disturbing when I hear the millionaire or billionaire word. And I've told them to stop it, knock it off. Because everyone wants to do really well. And this is the world of aspirations.
Then are you worried that the Democratic Party is going too far to the left?
So much so, it drives me nuts. So much so, it would make me quit the party. And I've made it very clear, I'll cut your money off. And others will do the same. We've had enough.
Okay.
We need a new brand.
And what is that brand? Because right now there is an opportunity. If Democrats lose, for example, in the state of Virginia, if that isn't a wake-up call that the Democratic leadership needs to get together and say, we've got to find a middle ground. Because if the Democrats continue to go far to the left, you've got that whole group in the center that aren't going to go the way of Elizabeth Warren or Bernie Sanders. And then you're going to fracture the party even more.
It's fractured. It's broken. We need a new brand. It needs to be simple. Keep it simple. Tax reform, keep it simple. Infrastructure, no bumps in the road. What more do we have to say? They need to have a new brand created.
Is the Democratic Party in worse shape than Republicans?
They're both insane.
But at the end of the day, like them or not, as I said earlier, there's a lot of people that don't like President Trump, but then they showed up and voted Republican. Are we going to see Democrats pull it together and vote together? A lot of Bernie supporters did not turn and vote for Hillary. They just didn't vote at all.
I know, and I can tell you that if we go far left, I'm out. I'm out. We need middle ground.
So when you tell the Democratic leadership this, when you meet with Wyden and Pelosi and Schumer, what do they say to you?
Well, so far they've given me great signals that they're willing to participate and get there. We shall see. We shall see.
Do you think this tax plan is going to get voted through? I mean, Republicans need a win here. Even if it doesn't work for their state, if Paul Ryan doesn't get this through, he's got no future. They will have no legislative wins for 2017.
Well, they have a lot of difficulties. They are very, unfortunately, bigoted, anti-Semitic, and caustic, and they're creating civil war.
They want to create a civil war. Steve Bannon wants a civil war.
100%. It's disgusting.
Okay.
And you wanted to talk about gun control? Get rid of the assault weapons. Get rid of them.
And Steve, tell me this. If it's bigoted, if it's anti-Semitic, if it's caustic, why is it winning?
Good question. A sad state for us.
Then what needs to be done? You need to run for governor of the state of Nevada?
No.
In short, what needs to be done? Like, here we are on the eve of tax reform.
We need people getting together in a room and be moderate with one another. We need to get along. We need to be able to speak and get things done. And we need compromise. Compromise.
Okay, then just answer me this before we go. I understand why the forgotten American, why Trump's base said, I want to break the system. The system isn't working for me. When Trump said, hasn't worked for you for 30 years, why not vote for me? I kind of understand that. But you're a big casino guy. You're a Vegas guy. You're surrounded by Steve Wynn, Sheldon Adelson. Why, if the party is bigoted, anti-Semitic, caustic, why are they backing it?
Ask them.
I ask you. You know them. What's your opinion?
Maybe they're confused. Maybe they're confused.
Maybe they're confused.
But look, I'm just as caustic and arrogant and aggressive on the Democratic side. So, you know, Trump-esque, Trump-light. But I'm willing to fight for Democratic principles. And I'm not going to give up. And hopefully we'll get our shit together.
And in your mind, the Democratic Party does stand for the American dream, and it does stand for free markets, and it does stand for capitalism, good capitalism.
Correct. And I hope we can get those messages out.
Good luck to you. My friend Steve Cloobeck, always great to have you visit. Up next.
You're lovely.